Hello. Today we are going to create our own Postgres monitoring system, which let us to know information about every query at the specific time range. So we will be able to know why our database was stuck at the specific time. Surprisingly, it took about half an hour to create this. All you need is just write a simple Golang application, or you can do that in another language, it doesn't matter. And you need some system like Graylog or Kibana or whatever you like to visualize the results. As you can see, I've created a dashboard that can show total count, total time, or max execution time of every specific query. You can even watch it in real time. For example, I can choose what happened at last minute, update information about every 2 seconds. So I've executed the query, select now, and we can see it at our dashboard. Let me execute some long query, like pg sleep for 2 seconds. Oh, I'm sorry. And you also can see this at dashboard. You can visualize it in pie charts. Or whatever you want. So, how to do that? What we need to create this monitoring? We need Golang application, pretty standard image and so on, nothing special. We need PostgreSQL with PG statement extension. Later I'll explain what is it. And we need Graylog. This local configuration I've copied and pasted from official documentation, nothing special. MongoDB and OpenSearch, Graylog need these containers. I've also copied this from documentation. STD out of Golang application will be redirected to Graylog. And this is all configuration that we need. I'm sure that if you are interested in Postgres monitoring in real time, you already have Graylog on production or Kibana or something to monitor your logs. So I'm pretty sure that all you need is just create this application. But for local development, I've made all these containers. You can find it on my GitHub account. The link will be in the description. What is PG stat statements extension? When you enable this extension, the view PG stat statements appears, and now you can easily get all information about every query that was executed in the database from the beginning or from last reset of statistics. So what we have in this view? We have a query, we have many different metrics. What we need today is number of calls, count of calls, total execution time. And that's all, but you can add everything you want. For example, we have this query selected from test, and if you execute it again, this count of calls will be increased and total time will be increased. So the main idea is to call this view every couple seconds and look what was changed for this period of time. For example, this second was 15, next second was 16. It means that this query was executed once at this period of time. The same thing with total execution time. And if we have these changes, we can divide one by other and get mean execution time, for example. Let's show the code. Main Go is pretty obvious. We just get some database configuration, and that's all. The main logic is here. We have here for loop. Every 3 seconds we get start statements from PostgreSQL and compare with values that was at previous get start statements and just log changes. Pretty easy. This is the main logic of this application. We just count some parameters, time div, count div, and exec mean time. We can compute it using time div and count div. That's all. This is being executed for every query. After this, we just output JSON logs with all parameters. This is just a flag that this is SQL stats, current time, time div, count div, and exact mean time. That's all. The application is very easy. No problem with that.
Now we need to create a dashboard in Graylog to output our information. So let's do that. But first, let's see how our application outputs the information to std out. Let's execute some queries. Okay. As you can see, we just have some JSONs in output. We have some parameters, a flag that this is SQL statistics, time div, count div, and exact mean time. The query will be in the message parameter. Now, let's log in to our Graylog. Don't use such simple login and password on your production environment. If you set up this on your local environment, you need to create global input like that. And some extractors. I've created a JSON extractor and I added key prefix underscore. I needed that to know which parameters are from JSON and which parameter are from Graylog, so it's just useful. Okay, let's create a dashboard. I have already created one, but I'm going to do this live. All we need is create some panel, aggregation, group by query. Query is in the message. Top 10 queries. Sum of count. And sort in descending order. Okay. Now we can see some queries here and it works. Let's do another panel. always grouping by message. And always sorting in descending order. Okay, we got two panels for that, and we need another one for meantime.
Exact mean time is being computed every 3 seconds, and here we just got the maximum of these values.
Also sort in descent order. Last 15 minutes, for example. Let's put it together. So we have all we needed. Let's just save it. And we can just start updating every 2 seconds. Or choose another type of visualization, for example, pie chart. As you can see, PGSleep for 1 second took all the time. So that's all. As you can see, it was very easy to create this monitoring, and PGStat statements doesn't take many resources, because it collects statistics in memory, in a small structure, so it's not a problem at all. One more thing I want to say, that you can use any system like Graylog for log monitoring, or even you can use Prometheus with Grafana, but you need to change your application a little bit. It doesn't matter. I'm sure that in every mature product you have log monitoring or some charts for monitoring I/O or disk utilization, so you can easily connect your data to your existing system. That's all. If you found this video useful, please like and subscribe to my channel and click the bell icon to get new video updates. Thank you.